Now let us discuss the topic for week 2. Marine diesel engine. Diesel engine type. So we have here our learning objective. Describe the diesel engine, also known as compression ignition engine. Learning out objectives or learning outcome number 5. Compare and contrast large bore engines and smaller engines. So, during the discussion, we have oral discussion. After discussion, we have quiz number 2 for week 2. So, let us proceed. We have also here differentiate the different types of diesel engine based on their power output. So, small engine 188 kilowatt up to 200 or 250 horsepower. We have also medium engine 188 to 750 kilowatt. Large bore engine or large engine greater than 750 kilowatt. So we have also the different types of diesel engine based on the rotational engine speeds, slow speed engines, medium speed engines, and high speed engines. So we also discussed the diesel engines that can be categorized based on their different design and characteristics. So by power output, cylinder bore, engine speeds, number of strokes, 2-stroke and 4-stroke. Cylinder arrangement, which is inline, B-type and boxer engine or flat type engine. Piston and connecting rod, crusade and trunk type engine. So let us continue. So these are the content of the syllabus. So first, we have to discuss, describe diesel engine or also known as compression ignition engine. Diesel engine name after Rudolf Diesel is an internal combustion engine in which ignition of fuel is caused by the elevated temperature of the air in the cylinder due to the mechanical compression or adiabatic compression. Thus, the diesel engine is also called compression ignition engine, CI engine. So, in short, the methods of igniting fuel here this is called, so here the elevated temperature, so this is called heat of compression. So remember that. That is heat of compression inside the engine cylinder. So that is how the diesel engine air and fuel mixture is being ignited. So this is one example of compression ignition engine, which is marine diesel engine. As you can see here, so the fuel is the air fuel mixture is being ignited here inside the cylinder by means of heat of compression. So the auto cycle uses a spark plug to ignite fuel, but here the diesel cycle uses heat of compression to ignite fuel. As you can see here, so in direct injection compression ignition engines, commonly known as diesel engine or CI engines, so only air is drawn into the cylinder during intake stroke. The air is compressed, reaching the temperatures, pressures that exceeds the ignition point of the fuel here. So now we will be comparing or compare and contrast large bore engines and smaller engines. So by the way, we have here the large bore engine. So what is bore? Bore is a term used in describing a part of a piston engine. It represents the size of the cylinder in terms of the diameter of the cylinder in which piston travels. So the value of cylinder's bore and stroke is used to establish the displacement of the engine. So this is the formula of the displacement. Bore or diameter squared of the cylinder multiplied by 0.7854 multiplied by stroke or number length of stroke and multiplied by number of cylinders. So this is bore. So if this is your cylinder bore or the cylinder liner, so the measurement inside of this cylinder liner is diameter or bore. That is bore. So let us continue. So this is these are the types of large bore engines. We have here large bore natural gas engine, and we have large bore diesel engine. How does it work? So for the large bore engine, so this is a super long length of stroke. So this is your piston, and this is your piston rod, stopping box. And you have here the crosshead, and inside is the crosshead bearing. You have here the journal, this one here, and this is your crank pin, and this is your crank whip, this is your connecting rod. So without the this is a crosshead type engine, main engine of the ship, but the trunk type, there is no piston rod. So later on You can see as we go on, you can see the run type engine. So application of this engine, marine propulsion system and power plant. So marine propulsion is the main engine. This engine is used as the main engine to propel the ship or to run the ship. And the power plant also, this engine also is used in the power plant, the big power plant. So this is an example of the large bore engine, the the bigger cylinder liner. So this is being measured during maintenance, during overhauling, maintenance and repairs, gauging a cylinder liner. So as you can see here, so I did this before when I was on the ship as second engineer. So I did this job. So a liner is gauged by measuring the diameter of the liner at fixed points down its length. So all from the top down to the bottom of the liner, so we are measuring the inside diameter of the liner during the maintenance. So during the overhauling. So this is a example of large bore engine. So as you can see here, this is how we record as we measure here the side diameter of the cylinder liner, port and starboard and forward and up. So we record in this manner, port to starboard. So gauging point here on the top and down to the bottom. So we measure also forward and up, and we calculate the average wear down rate here for the port and starboard or forward and up, and we calibrated it, and we record here, calculated the wear down rate for the port and starboard, forward and up, and the wear rate at a certain running hours. So that is how we measured the inside diameter, cylinder diameter of the large bore engine during maintenance, during overhauling. So differentiate the different types of diesel engines based on their power output. Small engine greater than less than 188 kilowatt or 2.5 horsepower, medium speed engine 188 to 750 kilowatt, large bore engine greater than 750 kilowatt. So a small engine is the general term for a wide range of small displacement, low powered internal combustion engines used to power lawn mowers, generators, concrete mixers, and many other machines that require independent power sources. So I will give you an example here, truck engine. This is your truck engine, which belongs to small engine. We have also here car engine. It belongs to small engine, and it is used in automotive just like a car engine and truck engine also. Motorcycle engine is also an example of small engine. So this is B-type engine, as you can see. So now we'll also discuss the cycle use and efficiency of marine diesel engines, and we will also discuss that diesel engine is an internal combustion engine in which ignition of the fuel is caused by the elevated temperature of the air and the cylinder due to mechanical compression, adiabatic compression. So this is a CI engine or compression ignition engine or diesel engine. Uses the methods of igniting air and fuel mixture inside the cylinder by the use of heat of compression. So over here, we will now be comparing the Otto cycle and the diesel cycle. So diesel engine is an internal combustion engine in which the ignition of fuel is caused by the elevated temperature of the air in the cylinder due to mechanical compression, adiabatic compression. So first here, so this is a diesel cycle. So when you are differentiating the Otto cycle and the diesel cycle, as you can see here, in the Otto cycle, during the here, this is a ignition and combustion. So ignition and combustion. So as you can see, the pressure is increases. As you can see here. Whereas in the diesel cycle, during ignition and combustion, 2 to 3, the pressure is constant, as you can see. So how the that is the difference of the Otto cycle and the diesel cycle, as you can see here. So during ignition and combustion, but here the pressure is increases in the Otto cycle. So we have when the engine is running, we have four events. So engine running. So intake, compression, power, exhaust. So this is your intake. So 1 to 2 is the compression. 2 to 3 is the ignition and combustion. 4 is power. 3 to 4 and 4 to 1 is exhaust. So same also here. Here is intake. Diesel cycle, here is 1 to 2 is the compression, 2 to 3 is ignition and combustion, 3 to 4 is power, and 4 to 1 is exhaust. So when it comes to the relation of the pressure and volume, so if this is your engine cylinder, this is your piston, so during intake stroke the volume of air here inside the cylinder is higher from 0 to 1, so you can see. But during compression stroke, the volume of air inside the cylinder is decreases, but the pressure is increases, as you can see, from 0 to V2. So, the pressure is increases, but the volume 0 to V2, volume of air inside the cylinder here is decreases. So the same also here in the auto cycle. So as you can see, 0 to V1, so a large volume of air during intake stroke, but during compression it is decreases. So you can see 0 to V2. So the pressure is lower at the intake stroke, and it when in compression the pressure is increases, as well as during ignition and combustion the pressure increases to the maximum. So let us proceed. So what is adiabatic compression? Adiabatic compression of the air is fine. It's the compression in which no heat is added or subtracted from the air, and the internal energy of the air is increased, which is equal to the external work done in the air. The pressure of the air is more than the volume as the temperature increases during compression. So that is heat of compression. Heat of compression. Temperature increases, so that is heat of compression. Inside the engine cylinder, here this is a taken from the thermodynamics. So this is if we compare to the application of the engine. So this is a intake here. Here is the compression. service power and exhaust. So ignition. Combustion. Here is expansion. Power. Here is source. Next. So ideal Brayton cycle. Isentropic process, ambient air is drawn in the pressure with it is pressurized. Isobaric process, the compressed air then runs to the combustion chamber where fuel is burned, heating that air constant pressure process since chamber is open to flow in and out. Isentropic process, the heated pressurized air then gives up its energy expanding through a turbine, so we'll use a turbine here. This is a rotary engine, a series of turbines. Some of the work extracted by the turbine is used to drive the compressor. So isobaric process, or this is called also heat rejection in the atmosphere, which is exhaust. Now we have an example here, 12 Brayton cycle. So we are using here a turbine engine in this illustration. So adiabatic process is the compression, isobaric process heat addition or the ignition and combustion, adiabatic process expansion, and isobaric process heat rejection or exhaust. Now this here is pressure. This is in the reciprocating engine. This is intake. So intake of air into the compressor, and here compressor is the compression. And then the fuel is introduced at the combustion chamber. Fuel and air. Make sure, and it burns the fuel, and it passes to the air and fuel mixture, passes to the turbine. Here is the combustion. So this combustion rotates or spin the turbine blades. So, as passing through the turbine blades, the combustion, it rotates the turbine. So the exhaust gases will exhaust here. So the PV diagram, so one here is intake. So intake of air. 1 to 2 is the compression. So Q in, which is heat added. This is heat added. So this is injection and combustion. And here 3 to 4 is power or expansion, and 4 to 1 is Q out, which is heat rejected. Rejected or exhaust. So the same principle, but with a reciprocating engine. But here this is a rotary engine, which is a turbine, gas turbine. So when it comes also to entropy diagrams, so this is entropy. And this is temperature. So in relation to the entropy, to the temperature, as you can see here, at the intake, this is intake, the temperature is lower, and during compression, it is increases temperature, and during the combustion, the injection, and combustion, the temperature reaches to maximum, and during expansion 3 to 4. So here is power or expansion of gases. The pressure at the starting of the expansion is higher and decreases to lower temperature as it is the gases is expanded. So Q out is the exhaust. So the temperature decreases. So that is how the Brayton cycle of the turbine engine, gas turbine engine. So it is similar to the reciprocating engine, but the different here is the reciprocating engine uses piston, but here in the rotary engine uses turbine blade. So explain that diesel engine is in the contrast with spark ignition engine, such as petrol, gasoline engine, which uses spark plug to ignite air fuel mixture. So a spark ignition engine is an engine, is an internal combustion engine, generally a petrol engine. The combustion process of the air fuel mixture is ignited by a spark from the spark plug. Compression ignition engine. The concept behind compression ignition involves using the latent heat built up a highly compressing air inside a combustion chamber as a means for igniting fuel. So latent heat here is the heat of compression. Here is spark. So I already explained a while ago this cycle. Always remember that the Otto cycle, diesel cycle, when differentiating, that during compression, ignition and combustion, in Otto cycle, the pressure is increases. But in the diesel cycle, during ignition, combustion, the pressure is constant. So always remember that one when you are differentiating Otto cycle and the diesel cycle. So the difference between SI engine and CI engine, so you can see here in the SI engine, which is spark ignition, there is a spark, there is a spark plug, but here there is no spark plug, but there is injector. So the only difference here is the method of igniting fuel. Here uses spark. So when igniting air and fuel mixture, here use spark. And here when igniting the fuel and air mixture uses heat of compression. So that is the difference between SI and CI engine. So operational cycle. So now SI or spark ignition engines, which are also known as petrol engines, night their fuels on the base of auto cycle or constant heat volume addition cycle. So here the ignition is carried out with the help of a spark plug. One. So the spark plug. So what is spark plug? Does it introduces spark into the combustion chamber where the fuel and air mixture are present, whereas in case of the CI engine, it's also known as compression ignition engine, diesel engine works on the principles of cycle of constant pressure heat addition. Here the ignition of fuel occurs due to high pressure and temperature in combustion chamber, hence no spark plugs are required in this case. So because means of igniting fuel here, igniting fuel is using heat of compression. Next, so discuss the basic characteristics and operating principle of diesel engines. So what are the key characteristics of marine diesel engine? So we are we use an example here, a marine diesel engine. So combustion from high cylinder pressure and heat, not spark, better energy extraction from fuel than petrol engines, heavier than similar power petrol engines, expensive and equivalent petrol engines than equivalent petrol engines. So this is an example of marine diesel engine, turbocharged diesel models. So diesel engine named after Rodolf Diesel is an internal combustion engine in which ignition of fuel is caused by the elevated temperature of the air in the cylinder due to the mechanical compression. So as you can see here, the operating principle of diesel engine. So we have intake. So in the during intake stroke, the piston is at the bottom dead center or BDC, and then your intake valve is open. You can see. Therefore, entering the supply of air into the cylinder. So that is intake stroke. Compression stroke. So your intake valve is closed. Your piston is going up. Therefore, compressing the air. And that is all compression. And here, this is power stroke. So, spraying of air through fuel injector. And because of the heat of compression, it ignites the fuel and air mixture inside the cylinder. And it creates combustion and creating the expansion of gases, therefore pushing down the piston, and this is called power because this is when the piston is moving down, the crankshaft is rotating. So we have, as you can see here, so we have here exhaust, so exhaust stroke, the exhaust valve is open, and then your burn gases inside the cylinder is released or expelled through exhaust valve, through the exhaust pipe, leading to the atmosphere, and the cycle repeats again. So that is the operating principle of a diesel engine. So since I already explain, so you just read all this statement. So I am explaining based on my experience and understanding. So just read this explanation here. So as you can see here, how the engines work, working. So entering the intake here, intake air here, the intake valve. It is closes and compression, combustion is happening, and also the exhaust. So that is how the engine works. So I already explained this auto cycle and the diesel cycle. So just replay the portion of the video which explaining the auto cycle and the diesel cycle. So now we are differentiating also two-stroke and four-stroke engine. So we have here, so we have to differentiate in terms of construction. And operation. So in terms of construction, two-stroke engine, there is a scavenging port, or intake port. But there is no intake valve, as you can see. But here there is an exhaust valve, but it is not shown. But it is understood there is an exhaust valve. So here there is no scavenging port. Instead, there is intake valve, wherein your intake air is passing, is entering. So that is how the two-stroke and four-stroke Differentiate or distinguish in terms of the construction. In terms of operation, as you can see, so we have the power cycle, the four events. Which is intake, power, compression, power, exhaust. So, in terms of operation, two-stroke engine in one revolution of the crankshaft is equal to one power cycle. So it means the four events, which is intake, compression, power, and exhaust, is completed during one revolution of the crankshaft in two-stroke engine. But here in the four stroke engine, two revolution of the crankshaft will complete the four events, which is intake, compression, power, and exhaust, or in other words, two revolution of the crankshaft is equal to one power cycle. So in four stroke engine. And in two stroke engine, one revolution of the crankshaft is equal to one power cycle. So remember the keyword, four stroke, two revolution, two stroke, one revolution is equal to one power cycle. So here we will define the different types of diesel engines based on the rotational speeds: slow speed engines, medium speed engines, high speed engines. So major types of the diesel engine, so three basic size groups. So there are three basic size groups of diesel engine based on power: small, medium, and large. So the small engines have power output values of less than 188 kilowatts or 2.5 horsepower. This is the most commonly produced diesel engine type. So these engines are used in automobiles, light trucks, some agricultural and construction applications, and a small stationary electrical power generators. So this is example, this is car engine. So this belongs to small engine. So medium engines have power capacities ranging from 188 to 750 kilowatts or 2.5 to 1000 horsepower, 1006 horsepower. This is an example, Yanmar engine, belongs to medium speed engine. Large diesel engine have power ratings in excess of 750 kilowatts. These unique engines are used for marine locomotive and mechanical drive application and or electrical power generation. So this is an example of large marine engine. So this is either uses to the main engine of the ship and to the power plant. So let us continue with the diesel engines that can be categorized based on their different design and characteristics. So power output, cylinder bore, engine speed, number of stroke, either 2-stroke and 4-stroke, cylinder arrangement, inline V and boxer, flat engine, piston, and connecting rod, crosshead, trunk pipe, etc. So we'll explain that one. So this is marine engine, main engine of the ship. So we have here the following is the list of the power terminologies used for marine propulsion engine on board ship. So we have effective power. So power, the power available at the output side of the engine. So meaning at the shaft. Shaft of the engine. We have also rated power. It is the continuous effective power provided by, so rated power, so provided by the manufacturer of the engine for the desired rated RPM. So we have in the nameplate of our engine we have MCR, which is maximum continuous rating. We have also RPM per kilowatt. So it is written there in the nameplate, the details. So we have also indicated horsepower. So as the formula here, this is a metric system formula. Plan over 4,500. So P is indicated pressure. A is the area of the cylinder, the cross-sectional area. In is speed for the RPM, and 4,500 is a constant. We have also here the ship horsepower. So the horsepower delivered to the propeller shaft before being converted to the thrust by the propeller. So this is the power at the shaft, the propeller shaft. Brake horsepower measures the horsepower of an engine without considering the loss in power that is caused by the auxiliary attached to the engine. So the horsepower without the attached load, that is brake horsepower. Gross power, continuous effective power provided by the manufacturer for a given using defined number of auxiliaries at a normal service running condition without any overloading of the engine. So the maximum power, which is the gross power. Continuous power, this is a MCR or maximum continuous rating. It's the BHP measured at the power take off and end when the engine is running at continuous safe operation range outside any time limit. So it is written in the nameplate of the engine, which is called MCR. Overload power is the power excess of the effective power than the rated power for a short period of time. So there is an allowance, it's about 25%. Of the 100%, so it is called 125% is called an overload power. Maximum power, the guaranteed minimum low and or lowermost power value by the manufacturer for approximate crankshaft RPM is the minimum power of the engine. Astern output power, the maximum power engine can generate when running the engine the astern direction at angle at a safe condition. Maximum continuous rating or the MCR. So this is indicated in your engine nameplate. So the maximum continuous rating which is the engine is running continuously at a maximum service output without any problem. Standard rating, we have also power to weight ratio, main propulsion power. So those are explanation is being categorized based on the different design and characteristics of the engine. So here this is a bore term used in describing part of the piston engine. It represents the size of the cylinder in terms of the diameter cylinder in which piston travels. So here is the formula of the displacement: diameter squared multiplied by 0.7854 multiplied by length of stroke multiplied by the number of cylinder. So this is bore. So this is your cylinder lineup, and this measurement inside the cylinder called bore or diameter. So this is how we measure during maintenance. We are calibrating the cylinder liner, so we measure port and starboard and forward and aft. So we measure that one for the purpose of the calibrating. If it is still within the allowable limit as per the manufacturers, as per prescribed by manufacturers, the diameter of the standard diameter of the cylinder liner. So we have here the major types of diesel engines. So three basic sizes, which is small engine, medium speed engine, and low speed engine. So this is high speed engine, which is car engine. Medium speed engine, 188 to 750 kilowatts. So we have example here, our generator engine on board ship is medium speed engine. Large diesel engine, our main engine of the ship. So we have example here, our large speed engine, which is the main engine of the ship. So two-stroke engine, you just two-stroke and four-stroke engine. So I explained this already, so you just rewind the video for your understanding. So here let us proceed with the arrangement of the cylinders of the engine. So what does inline engine mean? The straight or inline engine is an internal combustion engine with all cylinders aligned in one row and having no offset. So as you can see, This is in a straight line, the arrangement of the cylinder. And this is called inline engine. Next. So this is one example of inline diesel engine. Inline arrangement of the cylinders, as you can see here. DR or align in a straight line. So this is inline type marine diesel engine. Here also. So the arrangement of piston here of the cylinder is inline. This is in a straight line. So this is an example of an inline type engine. The arrangement of the cylinder is in a straight line. Now let us come with the V-type engine. So what does V mean for engines? So the V indicates the arrangement of the cylinders. It means the engine cylinders are arranged in two bunks or lines on a common crankshaft with a specific angle between the two bunks in the shape of a V. So as you can see here in this example here, so the angle is usually 60 degrees, but some engines were 90. So as you can see, say the arrangement of the cylinder is in a V shape or V form. So these are all cylinders. This one. So that is a V-type engine. So as you can see, the clips here, how this V-type engine is operating. So you can see clearly by watching this video clips. So that is your V-type engine. So we have also here flat engine. So a flat engine is also known as horizontally opposed engine. It's a piston engine where the cylinders are located on either side of the central crankshaft. It is effectively a V engine with 180 degree angle between the cylinder bunks. So this one, the arrangement of the piston is on the side, both side horizontally. So as you can see, so that is a video clip of flat engine, or in other terms they call this engine a boxer engine or flat engine. So these engines are usually in a Subaru cars, automobiles. Subaru, different models of Subaru cars and SUV use this boxer engine or flat engine on their cars. So we have here piston and piston rod. So a piston is moving this enclosed in a cylinder, which is made gas tight by piston rings. This moves inside the cylinder as a liquid of gas inside the cylinder expands and contracts. Piston is in the transformation of heat energy into mechanical work and vice versa. So the cycle repeated itself at all times while the piston is run, while the engine is running. So in a piston engine, a piston rod joins a piston to the crosshead and thus to the connecting rod that drives the crankshaft. So this is an example of trunk type engine. The piston, there is a piston rod. But in the trunk type engine, there is no piston rod because the connecting rod is directly connected to the piston. Whereas here, in the crosshead type, the connecting rod is connected in the crosshead to the piston rod. So a connecting rod, also called as con rod, is a part of a piston engine which connects the piston to the crankshaft together with the crank or the what we call the crosshead. So a connecting rod converts the reciprocating motion of the piston into the rotation of the crankshaft. So this is your connecting rod. So this is an example of the trunk type engine, because the connecting rod is directly connected to the piston. So piston and connecting rod. So this is your piston and this is your connecting rod. So a crosshead is a mechanism used as part of the side trunk linkages of long reciprocating engines and reciprocating compressors to eliminate sideways pressures on the piston. Also, crosshead enables to the connecting rod to freely move outside the cylinder. So here, this is an example. So this is a crosshead type engine. So in a crosshead type engine, there is a piston rod and crosshead. But in the trunk type engine, there is no crosshead and piston rod because your connecting rod is directly connected to the piston. So trunk piston is a term usually given to the piston in four-stroke medium engines. These pistons have composite design which comprises of thin section alloy steel piston crown along with aluminum alloy skirt. So the skirt consists of space for guardian pin which transmit power to the connecting rod. So this is an example. This is a trunk type piston. So the connecting rod is directly connected to the piston, whereas in the crosshead type engine, the connecting rod is connected to the crosshead and crosshead is connected to the what we call the piston rod. Yeah, and piston rod is connected to the piston. So this is the end of discussion. I hope you learned something in this video discussion with regards to the internal combustion engine. So if please click like and share, please write a comment below, and if you are new in this channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon so that you will know if there is a new video in this channel. Thank you for watching and see you on my next video discussion.